hi guys. So this is new, huh? I totally just asked. He was like, oh shit, am I doing the intro? You doing the intro? What are we doing? And he's just like, ah, beep, beep. Here comes the bus. Hopefully you can hear us and stuff now. We are here with the first of our post-Judas Deer Friday games. Now, if you're wondering, what the fuck is this? First of all, it's new. Second of all, it's basically an extension of what we were doing on Mondays off stream, where we get you guys to come play games with us. And you'll see, I'm not going to say new face, because I'm pretty sure Devour has been on stream at least once before, I can think of.
Once.
Yeah. So I'm not wrong.
The only thing you guys missed, because I muted my damn self, was me saying that I was throwing Zamek on the bus, and I did not tell him until just now that he was doing the intro.
Oh, well, there we go. Yeah, because I can definitely hear myself, like, fucking full on monologuing and shit. So, anyway, what we're doing, Fridays. Basically, Dredna, he's that way, he's down there, right in the corner. And I will be alternating Fridays, where I'm GMing this week, he'll be GMing next week. And basically, we'll be going blah, 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 back and forth. And I'll probably mostly be running Dungeons and Dragons. Maybe a little bit of Lasers and Feelings. Who knows? We'll see what happens. I believe Dreadnought is looking to run more Dungeon Worlds.
Who? Dreadnought? I don't know who Dreadnought
is. Dreadnought! Dreadnought! He'll be running Dungeon World in the 1940s in Chicago.
Dude. Dreadnought.
Actually.
Dreadnought. That sounds kind of badass. Yeah, that's pretty great.
That's just going to be a mega right.
Sounds good.
Fuck whatever you had planned.
What are you talking about?
You guys should know who I am by now. Although saying that, we're in a new time slot, so you might not know. I'm Zymac. I do most of the mapping around here. So the maps you see on Judas Deer and Hellmouth and the map you saw in Everdeep yesterday was mostly me. Usually it's Squeegee and I. We collaborate on that stuff. But anyway, I'm the co-host for most of the stuff. I'm on here nearly every day. And I am now running games on Fridays after Judas Deer, and I'm really fucking excited about it. I'll go around and let people introduce themselves. And you know what? We haven't seen Devour on screen other than that one time before. So who the fuck are you, Devour?
Hi.
Other than that asshole that wins everything, ever.
I'm sorry about that.
Seriously, Devour has won more giveaways than any other person in this community, and he has won a lot of them. I think I owe you two books and probably a new car at this rate. Like,
I guess so. I mean, RNGesus is kind to me. We're on good terms. I play a lot of Hearthstone, so maybe it's like some luck from that rubbing off, you know. I'm Devour. I watch the stream sometimes. Quite into RPGs recently.
Okay, you sometimes hang out on the Discord server as well, right?
Oh yeah, sometimes.
Do you have a Twitter? Well.
I do. It's same name as my username. So if you want to check that out for some reason. With all three V's.
Yep.
It's important.
It is. Cool. Okay. We'll do people intros, then we'll do a quick character intro, and then we'll just start getting on with stuff because it's already running on. So it was Squeegee. Who the fuck are you? That one. Not the other one. You.
I am actually Victor Sunshine in disguise.
My name is Jessica.
My name is Jessica. No, okay. I'm Evil Squeegee. This is my channel you're watching. If you're sticking around, you just watched us play Judas Deer. I do a whole lot of dungeon mastering. I do a whole lot of game mastering. I run games almost every day on this channel. You can catch us on this channel live every single day, 10 a.m. EST, except for Saturdays. We go live at 4 p.m. EST because I need to sleep on occasion. And then I also do like how-to workshop stuff, and follow me on Snapchat and Twitter and Facebook and Steam and Discord, but mostly Snapchat.
We even have a hype mark for that.
We do. Yeah. We totally do. And today, I get to be a player! I'm not gonna be the DM. Zangmax is gonna take his vengeance on me for Frankie. It's basically what I'm envisioning is gonna happen here.
I'm hoping. I'll get to that in a minute, but yeah, right, I'm hoping. Right. Okay, so, Victor Sunshine. Is this 2 for 2? Because you were here yesterday?
Yeah. It seems to be like a thing now again that I'm in everything. Well,
it's because you have fabulous soap opera.
I fucking love unicorns.
What the hell, all of you? I'm Victor Sunshine. I'm hanging out on the Nerd Discord, playing in quite a lot of the one shots. It's become a thing that I'm a unicorn, and I get read a lot. So,
this Victor is the reddest man alive. Okay?
He just is.
I'm like out of the coloring on the camera.
Like literally, as soon as you embarrass him in the slightest, or make like a lewd joke or something like that,
penis, Victor.
I think you reddened a bit there.
I love it.
Oh yeah.
Much as red.
I can't believe that worked.
And this is why we love Victor, because he's amazing. So, Dread Noir, who are you?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And it is evening because I'm in BST, not Evil Squeegee time. That's badass something time.
Was it BST?
BST.
The Meridian, motherfucker.
Badass Scotland time.
Yeah, that. And yeah, I'm Sam /Dread/Dreadnoir now, I guess.
Dreadnoir.
And you can catch me on here doing mod things. You can catch me on Discord doing everyone. You can catch me on stream coming up Thursdays, Mondays.
What's happening Thursday, Sam?
There's a clip in Nerd Herd that you can visit that will show you.
Thursdays is the day we air Tiny Tales, which is our 10-episode short-form campaigns, and we're going to be playing werewolves. And what noise do werewolves make, Sam?
Lame.
Wow.
All right.
Wow. Okay, so today, what we're going to be doing is killing Evil Squeegee. He doesn't know this, but I have a backup character literally ready to splat him, and so he can play. No, I don't really. It's fine. This is actually
It wouldn't be the first time I've been super excited about the overpowered build that I came up. By the way, I screwed it up. It's not overpowered as I thought it was. Right? But fine. I thought I had the super OP build for today's stream, and it wouldn't be the first time a GM that I played under had been like, all right, so you die, and you're playing this backup character I built for you. They're like, fuck!
Son of a bitch! This is the first time I've actually run a game for, like, fifth level characters, so I'm hoping I've balanced it sufficiently well, and if you all die, well, fuck it. You deserve it. So, let's do a quick round of character introductions, because everyone has a character, and we need to know who you're playing. So, Devour, who are you playing today?
Hi. I'm playing Falco Tinyfoot. He's a halfling monk. He's hot-headed, and hot-footed, and hot-fisted. As he's an elemental monk, he's yes, definitely hot-fisted. he has a bit of a shady sort of background. He's a criminal. He has used his monk talents for not the right causes, probably way too much. Mostly have been sort of shady and not too noble, but you know. He is a very sort of, what's the word? That doesn't care about risks, sort of likes taking them, and just likes to get heading into a fight.
The word
and,
you're looking for there is Kajer.
There we go.
I think it's yes. For bold, not stupid.
Okay. So that is Falco Tinyfoot. Tinyfoot, yeah. Falco Tinyfoot. Squeechy, who are you playing today?
I think it would be better if I did my intro after Sam. Like, legitimately, I think that my intro makes a lot more sense of Sam.
Victor, who are you playing today?
Today?
Yeah, it's fine.
I'm playing a Blast from the Past. Cleric. A Tempest Cleric from the Inn, actually. With the name of Sterling. He was once in Holy Order and was completely brainwashed, but got out of it and now just roaming the lands. He has a weakness that because of some enchantment they use in that order, he can never tell a lie. So that's a bit of a downer for him. But he's the typical good white knight thingy.
Okay. Dreadnought?
Greetings, people of twitch.tv/evilsqueegee. My name is Varothen, but you will refer to me as Heartbane, for no mortal actually knows my real name. I am mortal myself, I feel like I need to point that out. I realize there is some confusion with knowing demons' proper names and having control and that kind of thing, but no. I am immortal, but no one else knows my real name. A long time ago, I was walking down a long and dusty road when I happened upon a demon. Luckily, I was prepared for this, and I whipped out my demon book.
It's a sex joke.
My demon book.
How to Demonology for Dummies.
With a masterful flick through the pages, I stumbled across said demon and read the Kiwi link that told me this demon's name.
I love it.
And thus I have control over this malevolent force. But I decided to exile, not really exile myself. I was a hermit to begin with, but I have decided to keep this entity shackled for now.
A demon, you say?
So on that note, Evil Squeechy, who are you playing today?
I have had many names for many centuries. They know me now as...
Craven.
The Craven. I was once a terrific and horrible god of tyranny and slaughter. I was cast down by heroes of ages long ago. I am but a shell of my past self. Some years back, where a mortal fool found me lying in the ruins of my decrepit prison. My true name, something no other mortal has ever succeeded in discovering. As such, by the nature of my existence, I am bound to serve he holds the leash for as long as he must.
Okay.
It would be so fun playing an evil hunter in this party.
So, I don't want to ask the alignment question because it might be a bad thing for the party dynamic at this point, but it's fine. So, very, very quick background. Skyland is my world that we'll be playing the D&D games in. Occasionally I throw Dungeon World games in there as well. And in fact, the last Dungeon World game we had was with Kajer, who made a volcano erupt and wiped out a mountain of orcs. So... This feat of brutality, this massacre of people and general downright awesomeness is basically drawn all of you to go and investigate from various parts of Scarland for your own reasons. Craven, Artbane, you will know each other. Falco, you won't know anyone else. And Sterling, you also don't know anyone else in the party. But you will find yourselves having been knocked out and awakening in a caged environment. I'm just going to throw you straight into this and put you on the map. So, as you're slowly coming to the room itself, I'm hoping it does move you guys over appropriately. You should be in the top left as well, which is really helpful, and hopefully you don't have any ability to see all of the things unless you're Squeegee, who did join as player, right?
I am GM. I mean, I am player right now.
Okay, cool. Because that could be really shit as well. I was just like, fuck! You can see all the notes and all the things that are hidden on different layers that may or may not be fucking with you.
I think I saw a slight bit more than I was intended to because of the loading, but don't worry.
Yeah, it shit's a bit of difference. It won't matter. Okay, so all of you will slowly come to. You'll find that your hands are bound in these cages, although the cages themselves are, well, they're made of bone. It's the biggest damn bones you've ever seen seem to be what is holding you within these cells. In fact, as you sort of look around the area, there's a smell of something quite fausty. It's like bad cooking. It's not all that pleasant. And then there's a sort of a thud and a tune, and your senses are slowly coming back to you, and you hear, "We chop some meat to make a treat. We add some space to make things nice. We put it in the pot." And there's a big figure in the corner appearing to chop some meat with the thud of this tune. And she turns, she's like, "We put it in the pot and... Oh, you're awake, darlings. Oh, it's so good you're here." And she'll put some stuff into the pot and move into your vision range, because I appreciate you can't actually see this. She's fucking huge. Giant-sized. Very much alive. And actually very pretty, as giants go. She's deceptively light on her feet as well. Like, you don't hear the standard thudding footsteps as she makes her way over. "I'm so glad you could join us. You're going to make such a fabulous addition to the meal, dinner."
I will look over at Heartbane. "She will make a suitable sacrifice."
I'm inclined to agree with you on this rare occasion.
You two, as you look over, there appear to be two other captives with you. Sterling, you find yourself in a cage with a strange halfling. Falco, you're in a cage with an odd, silver-haired, blue-eyed... That is right for Sterling, right? Silver hair, blue eyes. Elf.
Who could have guessed? Yes, elf.
This is odd.
"I'm my fucking dad. Victor's playing an elf. Look at my fucking shock face. And then fucking, I'm Victor and I play elves!
Maturity level just like skyrocketed in this.
It's so good of you to join me for dinner.
I knew that was one hell of a night, but goddamn, where am I?
GM, I noticed that there is bones.
There is bones. Yes. You are in cages made of bones. There is a pile of bones.
My powers of observation know no bound.
It's astounding. It's as if it was right there in front of your face. Yes, these, there are bones.
These bones that are encaging? Is that a word? Encasing? I guess.
Your case.
Imprisoning. That are imprisoning us.
Yep, Morgoth! Morgoth!
Would you say, what size animal would you say that they belonged to? Or beast, or being, or creature?
Seeing as the community is somewhat focused on dinosaurs and art things, right now, I just threw that in there. Why not? T-Rex sized?
So in D&D classification, that would be either large or colossal, correct?
Large or huge, I think, is the next
large
one.
Large or huge.
Would you, okay. Would you like me to check the actual stats on an actual T-Rex? Because it's in the monster manual.
It's fine. It's four squares.
Four squares is okay. Large.
Large.
Three squares is
okay.
Huge.
Yeah. Okay. And what about behind us here with this these goat skulls, by the looks of it?
Oh, they're not skulls. Goats. Yeah, they're the horned skulls. They... you're into your dark things, aren't you?
Most definitely.
They're definitely not demon skulls. They're somewhat serpent-like in nature, but not... not dinosaurs, no. Something close to.
Clearly, and the skull...
these are unicorn skulls.
Exactly.
And the skull labeled as the Mortimer.
Hmm. Would you say that there was a medium or a large beast again?
The skulls?
Yes.
About the same.
So again, large?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Are you sure?
Are
you sure you don't want it to be maybe a medium beast?
I will try to see if I can get out of my bonds.
At your insistence on pushing this question, I'm going to say that it's most definitely large. I'm getting subtle hints. I don't know what it is, but I'm just getting that feeling that you need it to be a medium creature.
It's almost as if it's a magical spell or something.
I know, although your hands are bound. Remember that.
I will try to get out of my hand bonds.
Okay, so we're still doing that. The giantess. I'm going to go do my hair, get ready for dinner. Oh, it's going to be fabulous. I'll catch you later. And she'll actually, like, she's not your standard giant, and she will disappear off into the northeast corner.
Sacrifice prepares itself. Relief.
And I will look over at Heartbane. Finally, someone who plays.
She was a medium size, although she probably should have been bigger. Incidentally.
Are you sure she was giant sized?
So, what do you guys want to do? You're bound? Sterling, you wanted to try and break your bonds. How are you going to do that?
Well, what is this, like ropes?
Yes.
Are they like in front of me or behind me?
They're behind you, but you could probably slip them in front of you, you know, like underneath your legs and bring them.
Do I have my sword with me?
You have all of your equipment, yes.
Well, I will try to like get it in front of me and get my sword out a bit and then like cut it off.
Okay. I mean, you'll be able to sort of work your way out of the bonds without much problem. It'd be a pretty shitty adventure if you don't make it out of these cages, so I'm quite happy for you to make it out of your bonds.
I'm gonna, like, move over to his sword and, like, sorry, excuse me, you have room for one more here, please? Thank you.
I look around me like, no. But I will take out the sword and start cutting it off.
Thanks.
Is that the new tweet, by the way?
I don't think it is.
I don't think it is either.
Yeah, it's one of the mods needs to,
I'm not doing it.
I physically can't do it.
You will be able to break yourself out, Sterling, and Falco. You'll be able to. You said you were going to be able to give him a dagger or something.
Oh, I will take my sword/dagger and just cut it off him. It's fine.
Okay, so you'll be able to make your way out of the bonds, but you're still trapped in a cage. We'll call you your cage, cage number one. In cage number two, which, for the record, is the only other cage on the map. What are you guys up to?
I'm just a rat. Wrapped in a cage.
You're just a rat.
Okay. So the bonds I have seen are not, they're not like particularly magical or god binding.
No.
Alright.
Or fallen god binding, you know.
Would you say that an Eldritch Blast would be enough to just like the fuck out of these bonds?
Oh sure. Yeah, yeah.
Alright. So I'm sitting there with my hands behind my back, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now she's gone, and I will get Heartbane. Like, master.
That depends, demon. What do you have in store?
There'll be a buzzing of flies, scent of rotten meat. And then the shackles will just fall off of my wrists rotten. And then I'll do the same to Heartbane's as well.
Okay.
Nothing good will ever come out with dealing with demons. I say as I cast Shatter, or like here or something, to shatter the...
Nothing good ever comes out of dealing with demons. The demon will look up and say, I know.
Okay, so you'll be able to shatter... roll it.
Oh yeah, dice, that happens. Sure.
Yeah, that does happen. Speaking of dice... Some of you may be new to viewing this stream. It's probably worth catching up on a few ways that you can indeed support the show and or get involved and fuck people over. Although I think between some of the cast members we have here, they'll probably already be fucking each other over. So I'm not sure how relevant your fucking them over would be. Maybe you can help them or fuck. Yeah, you can fuck them that way. So, first of all, there are unnatural dice tokens. You can actually fiscally support the show by buying your favorite players and or the GM. That's me. Crits or Botchets. Check out that support link, which Ewa Squeegee has so helpfully put in. It's so unusual seeing him being helpful like that. It's great. Secondly, you can type in BEAT in all caps if you see something particularly applause-worthy, or if you think, shit, damn, that was amazing acting, or something was particularly funny. Or just, you know, there was a really good scene. Shout beat, and exactly. And what I'll do is I'll transfer a beat to the individual or the group, and then they'll be able to turn that into something really useful or slightly, you know, bend the rules a little bit. Because why not? That's good fun. You can... Ooh. Can your botch carry over? Did he have a botch lined up? Did he have a token? Is that how that worked?
If I don't think he bought a token, I think he bought a...
He botched you. Yeah, he did botch you the other day. I don't think you used it.
Oh, in every game.
If you want to...
Sure, no, I'd like...
Botch him, then yeah, fine.
He can botch my character.
So if someone could handle the sheet for me and the mod terminology, then that would be grand. So thank you very much for that, bearded noob. A botch for Squeegee would be fantastic.
Oh, that was earlier, Judas Deer.
It was earlier.
The Judas Deer stuff doesn't carry over. Judas Deer sits and waits to be used. Okay. Because it's a long-form campaign, yeah.
You can tweet today's retweet, which hopefully one of the mods watching right now will be able to update so that we can actually get an updated retweet for you guys, the viewers, to retweet. That is your way of helping us spread the the footprint of the show online, you know, the more people we have tweeting about us, the more people we get to come watch the show, and we get to do stupid shit about for people, and they're like, fuck it out, this is amazing, and they tell more people about it, and more people come watch us, and they're like, fuck it out, this is amazing, you know, you see what happens? Like, you know,
that's actually what enables us to put the show on in the first place. Like, this is what I do for a living. Without you guys, this doesn't happen. So the more of you guys there are, the better it is for you guys.
And last but not least, if you are this way inclined, then you can actually scrub-scribe and support Evil Squeegee on a monthly basis. There are varying degrees of subscription tier, and each tier will give you access to a new and increased reward for a different level. There are various subscribers already, but that literally goes directly towards paying the bills as well. So any support in that sense is scrub-scribe.
I don't know what the commands in chat are anymore, because I haven't done these in, like, years, like...
Good job! Did you update... Is he just doing the same tweet again? Yep. Saranus, if you could update the tweet, Saranus, that would be grand. Thank you. So, anyway, back to the game. The shatter goes off, and the bones of the cage will literally go flying. There won't cause any damage to the people around, like, or in the cages, but you will be able to make your way out of the cages.
I will be certain to be the first one out, so that if anything goes awry, I take the beating, not Hardbane. I don't look pleased about this arrangement, but it is clear that that is what the arrangement is.
And this is how we've conducted our business in the past.
Okay. So now that you're free of the cages, you notice the skull pile which you were referring to earlier on, which may or may not be medium to large, has two kind of draconic skulls, and then there's a human skull just perched on top of it, conveniently named as if it's an NPC that you could possibly interact with. There is a cauldron bubbling in the center of the room. There's some green fumes, smoke, gas, there's something coming from it, and it doesn't look altogether that pleasant. In the far corner of the room is where the giantess was chopping up meat, and you can see that there is some meat there, and there's some pastry tins and things like that. Yes.
How did you were of a particular strength, say 16 out of 20? An odd measurement scale! Does it look like that cauldron could be tipped?
Sure. Right.
I'm not going to at the moment, but it is something I will
keep. You could do. It's just resting on, you know, on the fire underneath.
Alright, so I could just like, hur! And send it flying everywhere.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Meanwhile, I investigate the pile.
Yeah.
Motherfuck. Like, seriously, the bugs around here at the moment are disgusting. So, you investigate the pile. Are you specifically looking at the skull, or are you,
I mean, I'm this. Skull seems to be in the middle of everything, so I would assume so.
It does. In fact, it seems to almost be obvious that the skull is there.
Yeah, then I probably look at the skull.
Yeah, okay. So you look at the skull. The skull looks at you. You saying anything? You just... I just have to clarify something. Did you two just walk through that gas?
If it was obvious that the gas is thick in the air, I would not have. I would have grabbed Hardbane's shoulder and pulled him out of it.
Yeah, the gas is in the air. Like, it doesn't look pleasant. It doesn't smell pleasant.
Thick and obviously gas in the air, then as soon as Hardbane started shambling towards it, I would have grabbed Hardbane's shoulder and guided him around it.
Wanted to check that.
Yep.
Okay, so you look at the skull. The skull's looking back at you.
Does it look like it's moving?
Can you give my account control of the other PCs as well for the camera?
Of course.
Right. So the stream can see everything, even if the party splits.
Yeah, I need to very quickly go into each of the characters. So, what are you doing with the skull?
Does it seem to move?
It doesn't seem to be doing anything other than looking back at you, looking at it, back at you. The tickets are now diamonds!
Now back to me!
With a blank face, I'll just take out my sword and poke it.
Oi! The skull says.
Oi?
Oi! He can speak, what the hell?
The skull will kind of like move back away from your sword and sort of casually float up into the air. You just kind of float around head level. Think you're doing, mate?
Evil or good?
Well, you tell me, you're the one who's poking me with a bloody sword.
I'm asking you.
Donation, Torgon, $5. Squeegee needs a botch. Hashtag lube your face. Who says hashtag lube your face?
He does.
Obviously.
That noise, that was a little bit too...
That noise was entirely unnecessary.
Almost demonic.
A bit too much.
I didn't hear it. It was the microphone picking up weird shit.
You know that... No, I'm not even going to go into it. It's fine.
Kogan say lube your face.
Oh, did it say lube? Did I do that for no reason?
Did you just throw a casual lube reference in there and then end up having to lick your own face?
For no reason? Did it...
Good job, dude. Good job. I'm good, mate. Thanks. I wasn't anyway until you started poking that... Whatever that is, Rand.
Skull, not that likely to take damage from poking.
I have a name.
So who are you?
I'm Mortimer. Alright? Not just any skull. I'm a barbarian. I'll bite ya. I'll bite you and all, you red fuck.
Stays from all over the room.
Your token's red, I'm assuming you're red as well.
Yeah, no, this is straight up to get the audience, like, this is legit. This is, I chose this token and actually built my character based
Perfect.
On this token.
I just wanted to be like, yeah, you red fuck. By the way, yeah, I'm no. actually blue. Yeah.
No, fucking blood red, motherfucker.
Okay. So, Mortimer ain't having any of your shit. And he ain't having any of your shit either. Oh. The Baker's Dozen would be perfectly fine as a title. If you wanted to update.
Oh, I'll update it, sorry.
It's fine. Sorry. You're discussing with Mortimer here. Yep.
My apologies for harming your precious skull. You seem to have lost a body.
Oh, I know. There's a lot of that going around. People say don't lose your head, and then literally I lose my body. Oh, the irony.
Yes.
Yes!
So, what are you doing here?
Well, I was just chilling, you know? Taking in a view. How about yourself? You come here often?
First time, in fact. Though I'm looking for leaving, do you know the way out?
I don't really know anyways, but I'll be happy to float along with you.
Bite things.
You're my guest.
I'll bite things.
Okay. Totally like blank in the pan face as I go start moving away.
Okay.
How bad is
your... Totally expecting him to follow.
So he will actually start following Sterling around. You have a floating skull following you now.
That's so in character.
So, meanwhile, in the southern side of the room, is your vision okay of everything? I even gave you vision on Mortimer as well. So, yeah.
I'm inspecting this table, picking up various slabs of meat and bone.
Okay. Yep.
And constructing them.
You're constructing them. Okay.
I'm laying them in an arrangement of...
Roughly humanoid?
Roughly. Roughly. Right. Incredibly roughly humanoid.
Medium or large?
Medium.
Okay.
Which, for those just tuning in who don't know a thing, means no taller than 7 feet.
As I see what they're doing, I'm just gonna, like, turn around and walk away. And shake the door.
And then I will animate dead.
Okay. So, there's a few things going on. Let me deal with the table first, and then we'll go to you interacting with the door, and then we'll get into a thing.
Yeah, God, guys, don't like, come on, just, like, split up. I'm gonna knock over the cauldron. No.
okay. So what's your intention with this creation?
To make an undead thrall, obviously.
Okay. Any particular thing that it actually? I'm just having a quick scan through the spell. But are you looking to make any particular undead thing, or is this?
What's the CR limit that he can make? Blah 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 blah. If you choose the bones, the target becomes a skeleton. If you choose bones or zombie, if you choose a corpse.
Okay.
So it's kind of a mixture.
To make a zombie
whatever's
skeleton.
Yeah, whatever's easiest or whatever the meat belongs to.
It's various humanoid meats along with various other types of bones. There's no animal stuff here. It's very literally humanoids. There's no
zombie is fine.
I'm just trying to find. Okay, here we go. I can do this.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I not tell you I was a necromancer?
It's absolutely fine. I can roll with this. And that is an actual zombie,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. So, anyone else doing anything?
I assume the tabletop is like on my head level, right? As a halfling.
You can pretty easily fit under this table, actually, because you're just a halfling, correct? So you're like 3 feet tall. How tall is everyone else, by the way? Just
6 feet.
You're 6 foot. Heartbane?
Around the higher end of 5 foot. So like, 5'10", right. 5'11".
Okay. I'm head and shoulders over Heartbane easily. Massive, big, broad, warlike shoulders.
Okay.
Like, the only reason I'm not large is because I didn't ask if I could be a large creature for fluff.
You're under 7 foot.
Unless the GM is like, I don't care if you take up 4 squares, then I'll take up 4 squares.
You can take up 3 squares if you want.
3.
What?
Like 3x3.
3.
Yeah, no, I'll go with the 4x4. I'll go with the 2x2.
Oh, 2x2. Okay. Yeah. Oh, so when you said 4, I was like...
4 total squares, yeah, no. So you'll let me be large for fluff? Then cool. I can't resize my token, though. You're going to do that for me.
Okay.
When you get the chance, because I know you're setting up a fucking zombie token because Sam was a dick and didn't tell you that you were going to need to prep that.
Absolutely fine. You see, because what I've been doing is casually filling in whilst we're doing this. And you should, Sam, have access to a new
fuck
sheet.
Fuck you, zombie. Yeah.
Yep, there you go. Fucking nailed it.
Thumbs up.
So you have a fuck you zombie, and Victor... You were opening the door, correct? Fucking bugs, man. You got to open the door?
Well, checking it.
Okay. It doesn't appear to be trapped. It's just locked. As you go to open the handle?
Mm-hmm. Well.
We'll take top of the hour and find out what happens.
Dun, dun, dun!
Dun, dun, dun!
D&D, motherfucker, let's do this.
Okay. Also, good job on fixing the fucking logos so they actually have sound.
I didn't.
I heard them.
They have sound, but that's not because I did anything.
You could have just, like, sucked it up and gone, yeah.
Yeah, but that wouldn't have been nearly as funny. I'm in showbiz. Come on, man.
All right, okay. So, as you go to open the door, it doesn't open. It's clearly locked. However... You feel like a breeze building up in the corner, and all those bones that you shattered of the cages that you were stuck in are beginning to sort of lift off of the ground and levitate, and then they start to kind of spin around each other, and then they split into two groups of bone swirliness.
They have curved pathitude.
They have great bone swirlitude. and in they basically begin to coalesce and form into two very distinct clusters of bone. One appears to be
this is the cages. A bit,
this the cages and the bone pile and the heads basically have all kind of like swirled into a big mass, split into two, and formed into one and two creatures. I hope you can see the names.
Can see Koi. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can see Koi and Mook.
I'm so disappointed I didn't scroll up and see Hammer as the next monster's name.
A little bit.
You've let me down, Zangmac.
Have I? Think about it. There is a reference here.
I know. Mm-hmm. It's not a flayed Bobby reference, but it's a reference. Thumbs up.
It's a Star Trek one. Reference. Come on. Like, it's good. Fuck off. So, so you guys down south, you'll feel this kind of this wind pick up as well, and you know what? We're just going to jump straight into it. Because they can't really talk, but they don't seem to be particularly impressed that you're trying to leave the area. We'll let you guys go first. Because I want to see just how nasty this is going to be. So, what we'll do is we'll run like the Hellmouth Initiative, which I know is from the DMG. But how that works, if you're not familiar with that, is it's faction-based. So I let the faction go, and then the faction go. If I surprise them with a monster, then fuck them, I get to go first. If it's evens, I'll just let them go first. You're not particularly surprised. There was a long, delayed intro for these creatures. So, yeah, go for it.
As these bones are animating, I'm just going to turn around after creating my zombie and turn it. How very typical. That is precisely what I had planned. But alas, I have not gained enough power from my solitude to conjure such beasts.
That's inspiration, isn't it?
I'm going to look in. Shit, what are my inspiration traits while we're at it?
Whilst you're looking at that, inspiration, guys! Everyone has four things on their character sheet. Now, those four things are... A... personality trait, an ideal, a bond, and flaw. Now, when any of the players act out one of these things, and I will probably forget that they've done these things, so it's up to them to go, "Hey, I did my thing!" And I'll be like, "Sure, you can have inspiration." And you can use inspiration as and when you like to give yourself advantage on a roll. On that note, did that fill enough time for you to have a little look?
Yeah, cool. So, my bond is I protect he who cannot protect himself, and given how fucking wrinkly old man over here can't go toe-to-toe with big ones, right? Mm-hmm. He's like, "Hey, I have not enough power," and I'm gonna look over kind of irritated and be like, "Which one first, windbag?"
So, as he turns around, "You're pushing yourself, demon. Remember who has the key." And I will cast Rave Enfeeblement on MC.
Okay. And just when you said, "I'm sorry."
Also, I got the key.
Yes.
I got the key. Another bit.
Yeah. That's exactly what we used. Like, oh, no. Anyway.
So I'll cast Rave Enfeeblement at MC. Yeah. And also, okay. I will snap my fingers, and the phantasmal shackle around Craven's neck will glow from red to green.
If anybody else wants to take their actions while I'm looking at my spell, while I'm looking at my spell options and shit, go ahead.
At the significance of this, okay, yeah. Basically, the way this works,
my intention for the rest of the party members is for me to go and hit the shit out of MC with a stick, basically.
It's Mook.
Yeah, Mook. Sorry, it's Mook. I'm gonna McStick, alright?
The two monsters are part of the same creature, okay? They're called McCoy, which is a play on Bones, which is a character from Star Trek, okay? It's not as funny when you have to fucking explain it, alright?
God, I love fucking with you.
You do your thing, I don't understand the significance of the shackles, but I'm sure I will do shortly.
It's just fluff. It's just fluff.
Okay, that's fine. And your spell you were casting was Ray of Enfeeblement. Now, I get a save on that, do I not? You're within 60 feet, that's fine. Make a ranged spell attack on a hit. So, you have to roll to hit me first.
Why did it not roll then?
Because fuck you, apparently.
You that's probably the name press of his zombie. Deck or
it's page. It's gonna be 1d20 plus 3 plus your int mod.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Nope, I had the output as spell card rather than
an attack. Than an attack. Okay. An 18 will not hit.
Oh!
Like, fucking excuse me?
Yeah. Oh yeah, I saw the fucking strength modifiers, assholes. Yeah, don't think I didn't come into this shit unprepared. So.
Very well.
I believe at level 5, though, you get second attack, or is that just for the melee guys?
That's melee guys.
I actually don't have a second attack. And that is just for the melee.
Yeah.
I would also use my reaction to cast shield on myself.
Okay, sure. Yeah, you might need that. Well, actually, you might not need that, but Craven might. Okay, so you still looking stuff up?
I know what I'm doing.
Okay.
I'm going to spend my bonus action to cast Hex. You curse a creature that you can see within range. Until the spell ends, you deal 1d6 extra necrotic damage to the target whenever you hit it with an attack. Also, choose one ability when you cast the spell. The target's disadvantage on ability checks made with the chosen ability. Choosing strength.
Okay.
Not say there is a save.
There's not.
He's just fucking hexed. So Craven is going to...
Which one? On Mook. Okay.
On Mook. Yeah, he's gonna hex Mook. Craven, like, the shackle breaks off and kind of, like, shatters, right? And then just in his hand where there was not one before, there is this giant... It's a giant maul, right?
Well, a giant maul.
Yeah, it's made of some, like, hellish black metal, right? And I'm just gonna look at it, right? And chuckle, and, like, the flies will start buzzing around Mick. And, you know, the stench of the rotten meat and so forth. And I'm just gonna walk up, and I'm gonna make my action to attack.
Okay.
Provided that I can roll like a god, because an 18 doesn't hit because you're a dick.
I have a question.
What?
Your the weapons.
That's a fucking nat 20 feel, son of a bitch.
That's pretty good. Now, this is magical damage you're gonna be doing to me now, or is it
the hex is magic damage? There's going to be a whole bunch of damage, because I'm also popping off a smite.
Yep, no, that's fair. And you'll also get a second attack, right? No, because you...
I do not. I fucked up my build. I fucked up my build.
Just very quickly as well, are your weapons silvered?
No, but the smite, I think, causes it to be a magical attack, which should have been most... I think.
If you wanted your weapons to be silvered, you can be.
Oh, well, in that case, why not?
I don't mind. Just throw that out there for you, because let it not be said that I'm not a nice guy.
Okay. I will not say that you are not a nice guy. All right. So I'm gonna pop. So I'm gonna get the hex die. I'm gonna get my great sword.
Yep.
Plus the crit. Yep. I'm calling a smite. So that's I'm gonna be blowing a second level spell. A first level. I don't have second level spell slots because I fucked up my build. I'm thinking it through. I don't know what I'm supposed to roll. There's so many dice. All right. So that's going to be smite damage.
So how this worked whilst he's doing all the things, he comes to me with this concept for a character and he's like, I've got this idea and it's going to be amazing. And I want to do all these things and all this damage and it's going to be disgusting. And now he spends 5 minutes bitching about all the things that he has to now work out to do. And you are doubling some of these because you crit.
Okay, so my smite damage totaled out at 3 because the dice really liked me. However, my smite damage didn't roll twice. That's why. Okay, so I get 8 smite. I get 8 and 3 is 11 smite 11. Damage. Plus 9 is 20 damage because I get the 9 necrotic.
Yep.
Then I get...
Need to roll a second greatsword.
Yeah, okay, so You know what? Fuck it. Let's just calculate the dice because the macros are fucked for some reason. I don't know.
Yeah, it's
being weird. Okay, so it's gonna be hex plus greatsword is 3d6 total times 2 is 6d6 plus 2d8 smite damage times 2 is 4d8, and that's all gonna be plus 3 for my strength. So I'm gonna do 44 damage to this fucker.
Okay. So you try, like, describe it. You're not gonna kill him, but describe it to me.
So, like, the buzzing and the flies and, like, there's no meat on these bones, right?
Oh, it's, yeah, they are clean.
Yeah, they're
but
clean.
But they're even yellowing, like,
until I've hexed them, then they're gonna have, like, the dried, rotten blood stains kind of, like, growing on them, right? And the stench is almost too much to breathe as I bring up the hammer, right? And it surges with power, and without ripping my headset out, so I'll actually be able to hear what people are saying. It surges with power, and I'm just gonna bring this thing down faster than I should be able to move. And just
so crunch. The speed of your attack is super enhanced as
the
well.
Speed,
like,
the speed of the attack, the strength of the attack, the black magic, the whole, like, let's fluff it up, I'm a fallen god, right? Just fucking BOOM!
And it will take the hit and it will it will lose, like, most of its rib cage, right? Like, you will literally just take half of it away completely. And it will sort of stumble back slightly, because that's a fucking hell of a hit. But
everybody's losing their minds and hearing songs. Yes, I'm still a badass god.
Okay, so Falco, Sterling.
Yes.
Yeah.
I would like to. At the start of my round, I would be like trying to look on top of the table and like, oh, okay, do you have anything good there? Kind of like pulling up and then like, oh shit, there's things going on. So gonna look over to the demon charging skeleton thing. Mm-hmm. And
there is loot to be won! Like,
yeah, immediately I'm gonna be like, hell yeah, fight! Wait for me! Wait for me, and I wanna try and, like, as he's, like, down swinging on this thing, I wanna jump on top of his on top of his shoulders.
Okay.
And attack from them. Okay. And I will use a flurry of blows, and I will use a Fangs of the Fire Snake discipline. So what that does is increases my reach by 10.
Okay.
And makes my attacks fire. So I will attack with, like, fiery sort of fists that are shaped into dragons, and they, like, kind of coil around my.
Roll it for me. This is going to be some acrobatic bullshit right now. I love it.
Yeah. Do I need to roll acrobatics as well?
No. You're fine. Like, we'll go with it.
Okay.
We'll say, I mean, Craven rolled a crit, right? So he's basically, you can leech off of his awesomeness slightly and be able to. He's not going to be phased by you climbing over him, and, you know, fuck it. We'll work on it. Yeah. It's good.
Yeah, go nuts. Like, you can just, like, run up the back, down the shoulder. Like, Craven doesn't give a shit. You're just a gnat, a mortal.
He's a 3 foot tall halfling, right?
Yeah, like, you're nothing. Like, go crazy. I'm just difficult terrain to you.
All right. Cool. All right. So I do that, and in the middle of striking, I, like, cover my nose because he's quite stinky. So I'm, like, punching with my one hand.
Like,
one fiery dragon hand. Yeah, like a boxing match, you know, with one hand.
I said big fat guy from Street Fighter. He's fucking just giving it like...
Yeah, combo. Yeah. Alright, so here we go.
Do you get advantage for being in...
You are allowed to give him advantage for, like, going over me if you want.
Yeah, sure. Okay, we'll just say, we say you have advantage on the first attack. The second attack will miss, but the next two will also hit. So, yeah. You all see right. Why having a 19 AC wasn't such a big deal?
if for the record, all if right. The AC is 19, then a roll of 19 hits.
Yep.
Okay, yeah.
Yep. So,
it was a roll of 18. Fuck off. Yeah, so we don't love you.
Roll me the damages for those. Do you know how this works? Yep. On this sheet? Have you used the SRD before? Yeah, you got it. You're good! Okay. 17.
And all of that is fire.
Okay. So you do, what's that, 17, 20, 22? Oh, so close. So close. He has no ribs left.
He might actually be taking hex damage. Oh. Double check. I don't know.
Oh, if, yeah, your hex, does that add?
Does it only add to my attacks?
Mm-hmm. Only to yours, yeah. I think it's played the warlock on positive.
Now remind me, the hex is the one you can transfer, isn't it?
Yeah, I can spend I can spend a bonus action to move it to a new target.
Okay. So you know what? With your crit, fuck it. I'm just gonna say yeah, straight up. You with the crit, the hex seems to work on this attack. It won't work again, but it's the first time we're playing it. Fuck it. It's happening. So you will just like fucking jump up this guy's back, run along. Start laying into this, like, laying into the skeletal remains of whatever creature this is, and you will just disintegrate. Like, the combination of the fucking...
Ignore that.
Oh, I thought you were actually making an action and rolling another 18. I was gonna laugh so hard!
So, I was just going through my spells, like, making sure all their outputs were attack rather than spell card.
Yeah. If you're unfamiliar with my GM style, I very much play the fuck it style. So... One down.
Hashtag fuck it.
Sterling.
Yeah. Seeing how easily they dispatched this one, I will not be very like...
You say easy.
Yeah. I will move slowly over this one as I take out my sword. And on the way, I will cast Spirit Guardians.
Okay, so this is an action.
Yes.
If you're
call
good
four spirits
neutral.
To protect you, they flit around you just as 15 feet for their duration. If you are good or neutral, their spectral form appears angelic or fey. If you're evil, they appear fiendish. When you cast a spell, you can designate any number of creatures you can see to be unaffected by it. An affected creature's speed is halved in the area. If the creature enters the area for the first time its turn starts to turn there, it must make a wisdom saving throw. On a failed save, the creature takes 3d8 radiant damage.
Ooh.
So you can give him like an extra of the secondary aura. Of 15 feet to mark that area.
And obviously I exclude even these evil bastards in my party.
Hey, no one said they were evil, okay? We didn't cover alignment. It's
fine. Well, I am a fallen god of slaughter.
He looks like a demon. He's and evil.
I took the folk hero background to like make certain people were able to be like, oh,
shit, recognize you. Sure, sure. Okay. So first of all, you've entered the area with him, so he's going to make a wisdom save. Which he passed.
I don't give a fuck.
So on a successful, I take half. So roll your 3d8.
Wow.
So that's 11 damage. On that.
Yeah.
And then I will. That was my action, right?
It is an action, yep.
Yeah, that's about it.
You are a cleric, right? Do you not get an extra attack?
No.
Okay, so the extra attack, the way that it works is that when you spend your action to attack, you can make two swings.
Yes, I don't think cleric gets that.
And spell casting is not an attack action, so even if he did get the second swing, he wouldn't get another turn he cast a spell.
I think the thing left is fuck you, zombie.
So you have Fuck You Zombie left, yep.
More
what's Fuck You Zombie doing?
So I'm literally just over my shoulder just been a go forth, my minion. And he'll move 20 feet.
Through the gas.
It doesn't seem to affect him, the gas.
Mortimer will bite this asshole.
You want Mortimer to bite him? Okay, so, first of all, Mortimer will be like, you need to, he's not just an NPC you control, you need to ask him. He's a real person, okay? Just because he's only a skull and happens to be floating doesn't mean he doesn't have feelings, okay?
I won't ask him. Will he attack the dragon as a barbarian that just saw the dragon appear?
Are you mocking me? Yeah. Oh, fucking butt. Ah! And he literally, his eyes burn with this fiery rage. And he will go in and start like attacking.
If he used savage attacks, that's a crit.
Oh, you are rolling the thing? Yeah, so he crits. That's 17 damage from the skull. So, do I get the go now? And he will be clamped on, by the way. Yeah, he is like literally like, like yeah, he's like angry. He's no, because that's slightly different, as demonstrated by Sam.
Oh.
So he starts his turn in the Spirit Guardians, I guess. So he takes another thing.
Is this another one? Oh, it starts its turn there? Fucks. So hang on. When the creature enters the area for the first time on a turn or starts its turn there.
Yeah, first time on a turn, so when he casts and then on the creature's turn.
Right. So it does double up. Okay. Yeah. So.
Half. Man, dude, you and these fucking saves today.
It's fine.
Like 21? Jesus.
So, what's that? 13 rounded down is 6.5 or 7 damage, okay? Now. He doesn't have the... He basically will sort of flex his wings and start to kind of try to flap into the air. And he will get, like, he'll begin to hover. He doesn't appear to have any legs. He's kind of just, like, wings and a spine. But the end of that spine looks particularly wicked. And he will look at Sterling. Look at you being all big, shiny, holy, doing all the damages. And he will...
Oh my god! Well, it hits.
I just like killing unicorns.
Why? I think the SRD is actually fucked up, by the way. Well, it's supposed to actually do damage as well.
That you click on the sting.
Oh, it's the same. Okay, so there you go.
Yeah.
So, DC 14 Constitution save, please.
Delicious cleric, nom nom nom.
So you are not poisoned, but you will take the piercing damage. That appears to be all that I'm able to do with this character. So, back to you guys.
I will spend...
Not to be a party pooper, but I think you also need to roll a con save for the concentration on the Spirit Guardians.
I think it's DC 26?
It's half the damage or 10. That's DC. Whichever is higher.
Oh, the damage or 10, so he needs to make a DC 16 save?
No, half the damage or 10, so whichever's higher.
It's going to be a DC 10 con save.
Okay.
And if he fails, his spell ends.
Nope.
He's fine. Okay, so, you guys, what are you doing?
Apart
from avoiding fucking
second
bugs,
verse, same as the first. God. I'm going to use my bonus action to transfer the hex, so like the swarm of flies and stuff will move over.
Can
my
you
mouse
just
will stop
get those
spawning.
Swarm of flies to fuck off, by the way? They seem to be affecting me IRL.
And then I will move in. And I will spend my inspiration.
Okay.
And
throw the hand.
No!
That doesn't seem to help.
Nope. So I'll move in and presumably not hit anything. A giant, like, as the bones move out of the way.
Okay.
Am I moving with him right now? Because I was.
You were on top of him, weren't you? So sure. If he's not doing anything, to be like fuck off. Like then.
Nah,
by all means.
Shit.
Oh,
slow down! Careful.
if we need to retcon something, we don't need to. We'll worry about it.
Can you give a 15-foot extra aura of, like, white or something to Starling so we can see the radius of his spell?
He specified no one else was going to be hit by it,
He
though,
specified
right?
I wasn't going to be hit by it. I don't know that. So I would have positioned myself out of it if I
could. Okay. Aura 15. And fuck you,
yep,
it's going to be
right
green.
Yep.
Speaking of which, as the dragon attacked me, I would have used my... my destructive wrath is, or is it Wrath of the Storm?
Is this a reactionary thing?
Yes. It's okay. Like when people attack me, they take the lightning damage.
Okay.
It's a dex save also, I think. I hate that I don't use the spell card. That's...
What I've started doing is I've started editing the spell cards to use the inline square brackets for die rolling and just telling everything to put out a spell card.
Okay, so what do I get? I get a dex save on that, you said?
Yes.
Okay. For half, or just for that to stop the knockback effect of that? I would assume it's knockback, it says 5 feet, or is that just the range? Whilst we're looking that up. Okay, so, Falco, you're in range. Also, fuck you, zombie is also in range, or is the shambling half forward damage. As much as it can do? Half damage, okay, cool. Thank you.
I mean, that's his movement, that's his action.
Okay.
Okay. I shall punch it and kick it 3 times in the face. And or...
okay, let's get the zombie attack first, and then you can no doubt finish it off.
Nope.
Zombie says no. Did you want to cast a spell or anything, or are you content to save them?
Yeah, you have an action and a bonus action this round. The zombie doesn't need up your actions.
No, I know, but I was just like Falco was declaring his action before I did, so... I'll be after Falco.
Oh, okay, right. Sure. Okay, so, Falco, go. Falco! Punch!
Nice.
That's a hit.
Falco! Punch!
That's a hit.
24, 22, 22.
Yeah, he's ridiculous. Okay, so roll me the damages. The number you're looking for is... more than that.
25.
Okay. Not much more than that, but more than that. So.
I will use the Sacred Flame cantrip.
Okay. Is this the most pathetic way to finish off a creature ever?
Dex save for you, Maddie.
It's fine. That will be enough. I mean, half is almost enough. But
they don't take half on the cantrips.
Not on the cantrip, okay. On the cantrip, if they pass the save, they take nothing.
You know what? He'll finish him. It's fine. So, with a final flurry of Sacred Flame, you will be able to decimate the final half of McCoy. And the dragons will be no more.
At this point, the spectral shackles will reform around my neck, and as if right when you weren't looking, I put it away, right? The mace is gone, and I will turn, okay. Stop, and start marching back towards Hardbane with a frustrated look on my face.
I pull my leg hastily away from the place where the shackles form, like, oh!
And like, ah, shit, my leg!
Whoa, what the hell was that?
Do you get rid of your aura, by the way?
Hmm? Yeah, his aura will drop eventually. Yep.
I think it's 10 minutes.
Is it 10 minutes, really?
Oh, really?
Oh, wow.
Concentration, 10 minutes.
Okay, so everyone else should actually be able to see that now. Sorry, I didn't realize that it wasn't on for everyone
before.
I
could see it. It was on stream.
You could see it because you have control of Tokyo. Yeah. Yep. Okay, well, that's what counts. So,
Oh, man, I could add them.
That's fine. Perfect. So, what are you guys doing?
Is the door open now? Or is it, like, still...
Have you investigated the door?
I will.
The door currently doesn't look open.
I will investigate the door by trying to open it.
Okay. It appears to be unlocked. However, I need to very quickly go, haha, Shazam! As if by magic, the door is now unlocked. Whatever spell was binding those dragons together seems to have gone, and the door's restrictions with it. You appear to be able to see down a hopefully relatively well lit corridor. Are you using your zombie to do you actually have like a link with it, or is it?
It follows his commands.
Yeah, okay. It follows my commands, but
so
I don't
if he
think
says
I see
go scout,
through his eyes.
It'll go scout, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So no, that's what I meant, like you don't have a connection with it, like telepathy or anything like that, right?
Okay. I will do cure wounds, by the way, on myself.
Okay. Roll it up.
Six. Oh, well,
six. That's right.
You there, shining bright. Could you kindly either stop that or move?
Oh, you won't be hurt by it, I say as I move out.
It annoys me.
Are these shiny guys with you, or are they cool?
It's a spell.
Are you still riding on my shoulder?
No, I hopped off when the shackles formed.
Mortimer will just casually follow behind Sterling. Okay, so as you look down the corridor, you see there's some large, like, rubbly boulders. There are these ornate, like, candelabra-type things on the wall here, giving the whole corridor quite a bright area. There is a big door to your right, actually, as you enter this corridor as well.
Also, hole in the floor.
There is a large hole in the floor, which the zombie seems to have, by sheer luck, avoided having to make any kind of check for, because he's already moved past it and I didn't catch it. So it's fine. So yeah, there you go. You have a corridor. There are some shelving units on the side here. And Mortimer kind of appears to be your shadow. So.
So I've just walked forward, literally just commanded to walk down, just walk straight. So it's just walked past, and it's got, like, it was, because this bit's not got a hole in it, right? So that's why it's walking.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. I mean, it's a bit of a squeeze there, but yeah, it's fine.
Right, so you just, Shamsley would have, like, knocked against the bookcase and just kept shambling, then knocked against the other bookcase and just kept shambling, and it's just gone forward and is now probably tangled up in webs, still just kind of, you know when, like, people lag out in MMOs and they're like just running into a wall. Like, that's what he's doing right now.
Okay. Okay, so what do you guys want to do?
Well,
you're presented with a big hole, some doors to your right, a well lit area, rubbly bits.
Well, I will check the door first.
It doesn't appear to be locked.
Well, then I open it.
Please. What?
I'll be pulling Heartbane out as, like, as I see the cleric moving, like, I'm taking a step back. I'm just casually, like, and then as I'm pulling his shoulder, I'll be like, which way?
Only the wicked and evil is in danger of my light.
Can you just, like, turn the brightness down or something? It's very infuriating.
No.
Hey, it's okay.
Technically,
I'm
that's
fine
not
here.
True, but yeah, you could, but you're not going to.
I could turn it off. I can't, like, just turn it down.
Actually, no. Okay, so yeah, fuck it. Take inspiration. No, you cannot do that. That is the hard truth. Okay, so in this room, there appears to be some kind of, like, growing area. Along the edges of the room are these kind of large planters, which seem to be filled with a variety of mushrooms. There are varying different kinds of mushrooms. There are some interesting shiny green ones which seem to give off some luminescence. The room itself has kind of got that earthy, shroomy smell. And there are, like, some spores hanging in the air, giving off some faint glow as well.
So seeing the cleric go into that room, it's like, and he's not turning off his spell, it's like, well, very well. Be difficult. You, demon, throw me across this chasm.
Knowing that I cannot twist the spirit of his command so I can't throw him into the chasm or, like, pretend to fail, I will do so. If you want to roll, I'll roll it.
How is 5, 10, 15, 20?
I could just throw him, like across this bit here. Right.
Oh, sure. Yeah, okay. Just, yeah,
yeah, so he's fine. Like, throw me across.
You can just
this.
Fucking reach over and drop it.
Yeah, like, I'm just gonna, like, pick him up, like, I'm gonna pick him up by the waist, gently, knowing that he does not like to be jostled, and I'll look annoyed that I have to be this careful, right? I will gently set him down across the pit. Can I step over with him as well?
Yeah, sure.
Alright.
Like, I didn't charge the zombie, so yeah, you guys will be able to just treat it as decorative for now. Mortar will just casually, like, float above it.
Just like fuck, you know. Woohoo!
Do I recognize any kind of the shrooms? By the way, you and mushrooms, they're everywhere.
Roll me a perception check, actually.
When the door actually, the room here? Okay.
Actually opens and I see the shrooms, I'm gonna run in and kind of look around for the good stuff, because I'm in the business for that.
Pair of 26s on your perception check?
Yep.
It was.
Damn. Two 19s.
Whoa.
The shrooms, they seem to be kind of medicinal or used in cooking. They don't seem to be necessarily poisonous or anything like that. With a perception check that strong, however, you will notice that one down in the corner stands out as different to the others.
Maybe because it's blue and everything else is green.
I will look closer at the one in the corner.
Okay, as soon as you okay, so you as soon as you stood there. I'm really sorry about this as well, but it will the blue shroom will just let out this almighty. It's a shrieker, and you hear a wet kind of plop type sound. That hurt my fucking ears. I don't know about anyone else. Yeah. Holy shit. Yeah.
I could tell it was a shrieker.
there will be a sort of a wet squelch. And there's also one over this way, next to Falco.
Oh, shit. Whole party is fucked.
Oh, yeah.
First and foremost, they take damage for entering my thingy.
They do. So,
God damn,
did you call them black pudding?
That's what they're called.
That's what they're called, dude.
That's actually what it's called.
It's like the baddest of the gelatinous things.
Black. I'm from the States. Like black pudding across the pond. That's actually like a food, right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So it's going to also continue that scream for another 4 rounds on top of the first round. Just so you know, you guys out in the corridor will hear this scream. I think everyone fucking heard this scream. Yep. But yeah. You guys will definitely hear it. Now, roll me your damage. Victor?
I've already done it. 11.
Mortimer doesn't even have any ears, and he heard it. that's how loud that was.
To be fair,
okay.
Eardrums are a bone.
That's true. oh, shit, that's the wrong thing I'm looking at. I'm all over the place. So many things to kill you with today. I love it. Okay. Wisdom save, wasn't it?
Yes.
Okay. This is probably going to sting. So that one and they will both take
fuck your fucking 11. Saving throws this time, buddy.
They will both take 11 damage. However, they did get the jump on you.
Wait, did they fail the save?
They did. Yeah. Does that do anything other than give damage?
22. I have been informed in chat that we know nothing about medicine and the eardrums are not bones.
I thought the damage was 22, but the other thing took 11 because it exceeded the save, right?
Wait, no, what? Both failed.
They both failed. The DC is 15.
They both failed.
Yeah.
They also move at half speed.
On, I thought the damage originally was 22, so the first thing, so Koi took 11 damage because he succeeded the save.
Yeah, but that was then. This is the same spell.
Yeah, you roll every time.
But the attack is different.
The 22 doesn't, like, 22 has nothing to do with this.
So it's not like the same.
You don't want to hold that damage throughout the entirety of the spell. No,
okay,
you roll for every
confused.
Instance of damage.
Yep. They also move at half speed.
Okay.
In fact, you know what? I'm going to be nice. I'm going to say you were on alert from that shroom fucking screaming like a little bitch. So you guys will get like a reactionary oh shit thing. So go for it. Sterling, to the east, there's a big set of double doors, which you also hear like a low kind of moan in whatever's in that room.
Yeah, first and foremost, I will tell Tinyfoot to, like, well, we should move back. And I will use Sacred Flame on the shroom.
which is probably the most ridiculous action declaration.
I will use Sacred Flame on the shroom. I know people.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, so you're using Sacred Flame on the left one or the right one?
No, he's casting the alarm shroom.
Oh, on that? Okay. It will hit and 8 damage. It's still alive. Although it's less of a shriek, it's more like a
Well, then I will be mean. Well, because I will move over to it and then back out again. So it will go into my guardian thing.
It's dead. Yes, your AoE fucking bullshit is killing the shriek. Okay.
So I will go like, how much do I need to go? 2 forward, and then I will start running backward. So I can run 25.
Feet. Like an asshole, the cleric is like, dead. Run!
Have fun, Mystic. Wow, it's the in-laws, so, you know, as much fun as can be had. Okay, so you'll back out. Falco.
Yes. Let's see. I think I'll just straight up run out and... Before I run out, I'll punch it twice and then I run.
Oh, you're going to punch it? Okay.
Yes. Actually, I can punch 3 times, can I? Yeah. See this black thing, oozy thing coming towards me, like, oh shit!
Okay.
Yes.
Now, you don't wear any armor, do you? Because you're, you know, no. Monkey like that. That's fine. Now, as it goes, that hits. Aww. Okay, so that's 18
Fallen
damage.
Fallen God indeed.
Okay, so you will be able to, like, punch away at it. Now, this actually has a corrosive form. So, the corrosive form, it won't let me do an output, but it says, a creature that... in fact, you know what I can do?
Copy-paste!
Yep, I can do that, at least. There you go. Okay, so, a creature that touches the pudding, or hits it with a melee attack, whilst within 5 feet of it, takes 4, which is in brackets, so 1d8, acid damage. Any non-magical weapon made of metal or wood that hits the pudding corrodes. After dealing the damage, the weapon takes a permanent cumulative -1 penalty. But it's your fists, so I'm not going to take that damage, but you will definitely take the acid.
And what do you know it's for?
So, yeah. But you will, now, are you, you used your bonus action to do Flurry of Blows, right? Or is that?
No, just a bonus attack from martial arts.
Okay, so you are disengaging from the pudding, or are you just running away?
Just going normally, gets a swing.
It's an action to disengage.
Did he take 1 punch or multiple punches?
Multiple punches.
You should take the damage for each individual punch. I am that asshole. But the reflective damage is per attack.
Yeah, I think so as well.
Okay, so take another 10 damage then.
Ouch, that burns!
I'd say I'm sorry, Devour, but this is what you get for not letting anybody win giveaways!
Driving people away from the stream or something.
Then, so, I'm sure there is a clip of it, Ash. I believe Bearded Noob has been clipping me a lot. Already.
If you want to find out what Bearded Noob is clipping, I bet you Bearded Noob is sharing those clips in the clips text chat on our Discord server at www.discord.me/nerdherd.
Or Evil Squeegee could just type hype mark Discord. Not Discord. And I can't be that smug because I fucked it up. Ta-da! So yeah, check them out.
As I run away out of the room, I'm like blowing on my fist, like, ow, ow.
Yeah.
Running away.
So you two, you've got 35 movement. You'll be able to get, 5, 10, 15. You've got another, 20 feet to go, even? So yeah, you're well out there. But you in the corridor, you see him running out, giving it the fuck.
Well, as the thing, like, as we hear the shriek,
yep.
I'd have just turned it just casually over my shoulder and said, "You there, check out that noise."
Reference.
Wow.
A moment will go by, right? So he's like, "You there, check out that noise," right? And I turn and I look. And then the monk and the cleric are both like, out of the room, right? And I will motion, I will say, "Done."
Okay. And that's all you two are wanting to do right now? Okay.
I'm going to continue walking, unless Heartbane actually wants me to stop. Like, I'm going to move my full, fucking... like around this pit.
Okay.
And I could probably make it around down here.
I need to, before you go back.
Going back.
So, you've noticed that all the way along this corridor, there have been conveniently lit torches.
Hmm.
Yes. So, give me a perception, insight, something along those lines.
Insight?
I'm not taking that. It's fine.
Can I intimidate it?
The pudding?
Botch!
You don't even notice that torch is conveniently not lit, so you carry on walking down all the way there. That's fine.
One, does it blow me up?
Nope.
Two, does it blow me up?
Roll me a dex check.
Dex save or dex check?
Save.
17.
Oh, you basically step onto this thing,
yeah,
and the floor falls away. You're literally mid stride, so you're kind of gonna do that awkward, like, almost lungy. Oh shit! All my weight's just on my back foot, or like you kind of like slam your mace thing.
I don't have the mace out because the shackles there, but I have huge hands and claws. Like I'll grab the wall or something.
Okay.
Okay. So
and you manage to stop your forward momentum.
Yeah, okay, so I'm walking along, and the floor suddenly, like, it crumbles underneath my feet. I'm literally just gonna take my fingertips and just jam them into the stone. Just, like, straight and just...
Okay. You see what you just avoided there?
I did. I have to step back here.
Yeah. You found it. It's fine. Okay. You were in the fucking corner. I was just like, no. Okay,
right,
so I'm just gonna correct my zombie's ineptitude.
Mm-hmm.
And just
how long does that last? By the way,
walk down until it's dead. Pretty sure.
Okay, cool.
The zombie lasts for 24 hours, and you can refresh it there if you want.
Okay, cool. Okay,
so he's just gonna keep walking, and he will just walk into the water.
Sploosh.
Okay.
Useless creation.
It will take 8 damage.
I nominate Sam for a beat for completely wasting his zombie.
Sacrificing
just to, like,
his zombie.
Just to play his character face palming.
Yeah, that's
how
fair.
Stupid it
you
is.
Can take a beat for that. Okay. So, that was your reaction. They fucked off. The puddings are looking at you. Are you wanting to do anything?
Is it our turn again?
I didn't take an action yet.
Okay. Take your... Mortimer's just like... He's a bit torn. He doesn't really know if he wants to go back and see what's going on. Or just straight up ignore it. So, what are you doing, Sam? Come on. Before top of the hour.
I'm
come on.
Moving.
Come on.
Past Craven, so I'm standing on the edge here, and I'd like to use Mage Hand on the door to see if it's, you know, if I'm able to open it or not.
Doesn't seem to be locked.
Then I will open the door with Mage Hand.
Okay.
And I will command the Craven once again to toss me across the chasm.
Well, if you hold on a second, I will describe
but to
something.
To find out what...
in fact, yes! Yes! That's top of the hour. To find out what happens
when we fastball special the wrinkly, tiny, weaselly wizard through the door that we can't even see through yet.
Come back in 3 to 5 minutes where I will stay manning the gun. In fact, you know what? I'm going to get a top up to my water. If someone else can man the guns, that would be grand.
Sam, can I nominate you to be thrown under the bus?
Beep, beep.
All right, beep, beep. I'm Sam, go! Welcome back, twitch.tv/EvilSqueegee. I am Evil Squeegee, but you can't see me because I exist in the Shadow Realm. Take it away, Zang. You're up.
Thank you. Okay, so... with almost supernatural thought and decision, Sterling, you slam the door shut to the Black Pudding Shroom Room, thus foiling the plot of the GM to pudding you over and over into submission.
I wasn't hungry anyway.
Fucking hot, man. This is getting close to not safe for work stuff.
The doors are shut, and you hear like a bit of a wet slapping sound as the puddings will try and start eating their way through the door. So,
well, I could technically just stand here and let them take damage.
You could, but we have less than an hour to go, and you've got more problems to deal with.
We leave the cleric behind to do it.
It's okay, guys. I got this.
I'm experienced farming.
you opened the door, right?
Correct.
Which actually does something rather surprising.
It lets us see.
The hatches that fell away flip back up.
Well, rip zombie.
Please tell me I can throw him anyways.
You could throw him if you want to. Yeah.
I did command you to, so...
Off you go. Yeah. Whee!
I will start moving over here.
Give me a d6 plus strength damage.
Plus strength, really?
Yep.
All right. Fuck you, Heartburn!
Can I do a dex save to take half?
Sure.
I appreciate you, Sam. Just so you know, I enjoy this.
I think I take half.
Take half. Yep, you're good.
I see that the metallic things coming behind you.
God damn! Yeah. These dice.
God damn! What a rush!
God damn!
what a rush!
okay. So, we find ourselves in another corridor, which looks almost the same as the corridor you've just left. However, this corridor has bookcases, not shelving. There are a series of books and scrolls and all sorts of other interesting things in this room.
No, leave me alone, Victor.
That's you.
Oh God, it's gonna eat me. Okay.
Slack, you would realize it doesn't take damage now.
Now you see, this room is other than these things that you notice. This room is exceptionally clean. Okay? The walls, the floors, they're immaculate. It's almost like dust has never even been considered being a thing in this room. That's how clean it is. There are bookcases either side, lit up by these candelabras. And if that's the wrong word for it, well, shit. That's what I'm using now.
I would like
there appear to be... Sorry. There appear to be a couple of chests on top of these bookcases, which would be fine if you were giant size, but sadly, even though you have the Craven with you, and he is a man-mountain of a fallen god, not actually a man, it's kind of a little bit out of reach for him.
So if I stand on his shoulder and Falco stands on my shoulders...
Yep. Yep. If you want to try that, that's fine.
No.
Is that what you want to do? No? Okay. So, it's up to you guys.
Did we just trap the zombie underneath the pit trap?
Yep.
Yep.
He's gone. I deleted him. He's gone.
And it's gone. And there is a door. There is a door on the opposite wall as well.
I would say, Mortimer, could you go up there and look at these things.
You died and made me your bitch!
I asked if you could.
You, but if... apparently.
That's a fair point. I mean, I can go and have a look. What do you want me to do?
I mean, if you could push them down, that would be good.
I mean, I can give it a go. I'm not particularly strong. And he
can
will,
you carry me up there, actually? I'm quite light.
Wasn't you a barbarian?
Yeah, he is a barbarian.
But he has no arms, Victor.
What's he gonna do?
I know, I have his sheet, but Sterling asked.
You know how shit his strength is! What's wrong with you?
I know, Sterling don't.
Okay, so he'll be like muttering going up, and will he be able to nudge this off? No. No, he will not.
Negative two? Did you just roll a negative two?
It seems that he is unable to push this chest off the wall. In fact, he kind of gets his head stuck.
Can he, like, lose the jawbone?
Yes.
No, he is stuck. He is wedged between the chest and the wall.
So how high is the table?
How tall are you, Craven? 7 feet?
If I'm large, I can be up to like 10, 13 feet. Like, I'm fucking okay. Massive now.
About 15 feet tall.
Sure.
No, not you. That's how high up it is.
Wait, okay, so if I'm like 10 feet tall, right?
Yes, you could probably reach it. Fine. Go, touch it.
I was gonna say, that's if I'm standing up.
No, you know what? Be my guest. You go ahead. Please touch it.
Can you tell me what my detect magic detects, maybe?
Magic? Duh.
It breaks on.
Whoa.
As one would expect with these things. Does this...
So Mortimer tries to push it off and can't?
Mortimer is currently wedged behind the chest and the wall.
I will pick up Tinyfoot. I will not ask. Okay. I will just slowly turn around, right, and just like reach down and pick it up by the waist.
You're not seeing anything on the shelves or anything in the chest that's magical.
Then
it's 30 feet around me, so like anything in this room, basically.
In this room, no. Unless anyone else is carrying magical items, then no.
Right, okay, so there's just a huge fuck-off glow around Craven.
And Mortimer. Yeah, and Mortimer, because he's a bit special.
Alright.
I'm gonna pick up the halfling and just, like, put him on the shelf. I don't ask, I just do it.
Careful there.
Okay.
So I inspect the chest once I'm up there a bit closely. Don't pay attention to Mortimer.
Poor Mortimer. Like, he's just getting all the bitch work. I understand his pain. I'm just getting something ready here. Okay, so you're on top. You can see Mortimer's like, can you
helping out before we do something.
Give us a hand here or something, you know. You quite easily unwedge him. He's forced himself in.
I don't unwedge him. I keep him there. Yeah, I'm like, you're fine, you're fine. I inspect the chest.
How are you investigating this chest?
Well, looking it over, first of all.
Looks like a chest.
I look for traps, I guess.
Okay, how are you doing this?
With my eyes.
There doesn't appear to be any mechanical traps from the outside.
Okay.
Are you gonna touch it?
Yes, we'll touch it.
Yes! 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 I love these! The chest tries to grapple you.
As the Craven lifts him onto the chest, so before he's looked at the chest, or as he's inspecting it, I'm going to casually turn over to my shoulder and Craven, stop playing with the lesser races.
Craven looks down and he says, cannon fodder.
And I will cast Find Familiar and go through the door.
Find Familiar?
Huh?
Wait. That's a big-ass spell card. Holy shit. So I basically summon my familiar.
Yeah, you spend an action, you summon your familiar. It can go into Pocket Realm if he wants, and he can dismiss it. He has to cast it again if it dies.
That's your grapple. On a 15. Give me an opposed athletics.
Can I use acrobatics?
Sure. Sure, why not? Just because I'm nice like that, yeah. So you've placed him up there, and this sort of happens as you're, like, having a little conversation. Oh, okay, he's got you. Oh.
So does this mean that he takes damage from my guardians?
Now? Yeah, sure. Hang on. Let me work this out. It's going to be gone after this room.
Yeah, that's makes sense. Yeah.
Roll the damage.
Now it works.
For fuck's sake, these fucking spirit guardians. I tell you what.
That's a good roll.
Oh my god. Really?
God damn!
It's fucking free damage bullshit, I tell you. It's disgusting.
I haven't even pulled out my favorite trick yet.
Oh, I'm waiting for it. I'm waiting for it. So, the first mimic takes full damage, the second mimic takes full damage. Yeah. Why not? That just happens. Victor, you're an asshole.
Thank you.
20 damage, holy fuck. And you know what? Okay, we're good. So, what was the bookcase, the chest mirroring this mimic on the opposite side? Takes damage. The damage will release you from your grapple. It won't actually be able to do that. And we'll do that. You go to the door. The door's locked. And you hear something from the halfling, I'd imagine, as he's attacked and... no, maybe not. I don't know. Would you be startled? Yeah.
Yes.
This is why I work alone.
So, guys,
now I'll turn around and I'll fire.
Is this all pre-combat? Or are we going through PC phase?
Go PC phase. Fuck it.
All right, I will spend my bonus action to move hex to the thing that hex lasts an hour.
Yep.
So once it's cast, like, it's be like you.
Dad, you get a hex. You get a hex. Okay.
And then I will fucking smack the shit out of it.
These poor mimics. I put these in as like a little kind of... okay, fine. Hit it. Go for it.
I'm looking for my sheep. My sheep. Is it on this one? It's this one. All right. Please don't botch.
Woohoo! That'll hit.
Almost a nat 20.
17 damage.
17?
Yep.
Okay. It's not looking healthy. Like, you're just chipping away bits of this mimic as it's kind of, like, tentacly bits are trying to grab onto things.
I'm swinging. I'm not really going out of my way to make certain the monk on top of the platform or the barbarian floating skull are comfortable with how close I'm hitting the mimic. They are also there. I'm not hitting them, but it's not like I'm going out of my way to use an angle that might avoid them, right?
You're not trying to stop hitting them. Yeah, yeah.
And then I'm like, wow! Right?
On that note, your attack goes through the shelves as well. Like, you just decimate the fucking bookcase and all the shit. So literally the thing will land on the ground. No damage.
I don't hate to be that guy, but if that's 10 feet up, a d6 fall damage.
Oh, you're an asshole. Fine.
I will, as a reaction, use Slothful as a monk and gracefully float
down.
And
now I have created a situation that rewards a class's strength. Look at me helping you.
Look at you. It's almost like you GM for a living.
Also, that applies to the mimic.
I already did the damage for the mimic.
Okay.
Sorry.
That's my bonus action. I would like to get out my sword and, like, slash in the air. And a sword, like, a spiritual version of it will...
Spirit weapon?
Thing. Yep.
There is a second mimic, by the way. Just
I know.
Yeah, but it's all the fuck way over there.
Like, two strides for you.
Alright.
that will hit. What is it with you and rolling double numbers?
It's that Viking Swedish mojo.
It's still alive.
Yeah, I will use, what's the name? The cantrip, Sacred Flame.
Oh, I didn't think to activate Smite.
That kills the first mimic!
If it's the deck save, but, you know.
It kills the first mimic.
You got a whole bunch of honest players going on today, Zang. This is really weird.
I know. And my reward for that honesty is to just kill it.
It's fine. I'm sorry, I'm a stickler for falling damage. That's
all. So once it's going our turn, this is why I will work alone. Take a few steps forward, throw out my hand, and eject poison from my hand all over this.
You throw out your hand and eject poison?
Yep.
There's no build-up. No. There's no build-up.
Hey, I'm not judging. One out of four men, alright? I'm not judging at all.
I suffer from PE, okay?
Rub it up for the follow!
I'm so surprised you actually followed from that.
2d12.
Okay, roll the other one for me then. For fuck's sake, really? 23 damage, right, okay. Any more?
Hang on, it must succeed on a constitution saving throw.
Yeah, con save for the mimic.
Yep. Or half?
Or half.
What's
or
the DC? 15?
Yeah.
Yep, nope, it takes full damage. But thank you for your honesty.
It's a cantrip, so it doesn't take anything if it succeeds.
Okay, cool. So,
as I'm gracefully floating down from the strike of the Craven, with the, like, splinters going about everywhere.
Yep, there's like a spray of...
Hurricane.
Sorry. Oh, you shurikens? Okay,
I will shoot two shurikens at the mimic on the other side as I'm floating down.
Roll them.
Yeah.
That hits.
Wow, these dice today, bro.
That hits. Give me the damage.
Both of them or one?
Like nothing, dude.
Roll me both of them, yeah. Both of them hit. Oh. Yeah, it's gone. Okay, so as you're just casually like, I'm floating in the... and off they go. And the second mimic is kind of tentacly splattered onto the wall. Done. There's a click on the door.
The shackles will rebound. Technically, they would have really...
Of course. Do you wish to go through this door?
Oh, the mimics have.
It's likely I'm going to be sent in first because I don't get to say no.
I'm going to actually tell you to destroy the door because I'm annoyed at the fact that it was locked when I tried it.
Do you require a roll for me to get through this door, Zangmac?
Nah, you're right.
I will. I mean,
you can roll it anyway.
Door.
If you want to roll it, you roll it, but I'm okay with it.
Nah, I'm not gonna roll if you're not an ass roll. I'll just fucking smash the fucking door with my foot, motherfucker. Eat goddamn.
And the door looks like it opened normally, but it's actually smashed to splinters because I don't have a smashed door token.
Here.
No. Nuh-uh. I don't want it. I've narrated it. It's done. Don't be giving me that shit. The fuck is Smash 4?
Amazing.
This takes me back to the poop dungeon.
Okay.
No.
Which I haven't played through yet.
So, what do you guys want to do?
Creature.
Sending me in, I'm going in.
I'll check the bodies of the mimics briefly, open them up, see if they have anything inside of them by any chance.
You'll find 20 to give you. You'll find like some gold, like some stuff that's not easily digestible, and like a glass vial with some liquid in it.
What color liquid is it?
Purple.
Okay. I will go up to the shiny man and ask, hey, you know what this is? Doesn't look like wine.
Pixie, your aura will drop.
Yeah, well, I will look at it. Does it look like a potion?
It looks very much like a potion.
I would say it's a potion.
I'm glad really? We had this conversation. What do you think this is? It looks like a potion.
I can see that Sterling here subscribes to the Grant School of answering questions. What am I doing right now? Asking a question. Fuck off, Grant! Like...
So, you walk through the door. You see this room. Now, there's a fair bit of misty fog cloudiness in this room. It doesn't seem to be coming from anywhere in particular. There is it looks like an arcane symbol and a rite of some kind on the floor with 5 torches arranged loosely in a star shape.
I will turn to Hartbane, looking at all this stuff. I will ask him,
throw yourself in for all I care, creature.
I will grab one of the bookcases and toss it in to see if it evaporates, eviscerates, disappears, summons a god, frees me so I can kill everybody, turns into cotton candy, or otherwise lowers the average price of dishwashers in my district.
You'll pick up this bookcase because it's the only one I can actually grab.
Okay.
And
I know those feels.
Yeah. And launch it through into the opposite wall.
Well, I want to toss it so it lands on the stuff. I don't want to like throw it through. I want to toss it.
You
so
want to throw it onto the thing?
Yeah, okay. I want to throw it on the thing. Just like
it lands on the thing.
All right, nothing happens.
Nope.
I can feel the prices of dishwashers dropping right now.
There's some explosions of.
What the? Bravo.
So, Mortimer will casually fly around the room a little bit.
Oh, fucking hell.
You there, Skull. Is this a place you've been before? I know you've inhabited this area as we found you here.
Can't say I have been down here. I was quite happy with my room. Lots of bones, company. You know, good conversation.
Speaking of company, who was that creature that imprisoned us?
Oh, Aria. Raya, I don't know. She says her name something like that.
I assume so. I believe we weren't formally introduced.
I mean, do you want me to go find her? See if I can give you a proper introduction?
You can tell us where she resides. Yes.
Please
you do. I ain't your bitch.
So rude, no manners. Invited us to dinner and didn't even introduce herself.
You are not my bitch.
Feels not introduce themselves.
I am a master of the dead. By one way or another, I will control you.
Alright, good luck with that.
I kick the door down.
Okay. Why do people just not open doors anymore, you know?
Motherfucker, this door is like the size of my palm!
Oh, I grabbed the map! Nobody look!
Nothing's changed on my end.
I got it.
He's fixing a tragic mistake! We're all on the door!
Son of a... The door is now diamonds! I mean, smithereens. So, you kick the door open.
Do I die?
No.
Good.
Sorry, you're not released from your shackles.
Damn it!
This room also has that kind of misty, smoky essence to it.
I can see through the wall.
Gosh, where? Which one?
Down here.
I will spare.
Oh! Don't worry about that. I can fix it.
Yeah, no, yeah. I'm there's taking nothing... it off the
screen. Motherfuck, son of a bitch.
Done.
Okay, it's fixed. Good. Happy days. Thank you.
We are the pinnacle of professionalism today, ladies and gents.
Woo!
Nailed it. Look at these mad, crazy mapping skills. Zang map, ladies and gentlemen. A round of applause. The man with the dynamic lighting.
Well, more like...
You know what? There you go.
Matt, how's brought that? To you by Zangmac.
So, you walk into a very warm room. There's supplies in this room. Some cobwebs. The supplies, just at first glance, seem to be more cooking, flour, baking goods. Things that you would make food from. There is a large open oven in the corner, which seems to be generating the heat. There are a couple of lit lighting areas to the sides, also generating heat. The room itself seems rather simple.
This room is much too warm for my liking.
I thought you liked
demons. And I will cast Chill Touch or Ray of Frost, either way, on all of the heat sources.
On the heat sources, okay. So you're just gonna cool, yeah, because it's a cantrip. So you could just like, so there'll be like a sizzle, and the heat will kind of like die down a little bit. The mist, incidentally, seems to stay.
I'm gonna look up to the necromancer, look up at him, and I'm gonna say, "You look kind of grumpy there. Come on, cheer up." And I will use my monk elemental thing that allows me to interact with stuff, one of which is mist, and I will create a smiley face like next to him. Cheer up, man.
The mist will pause and then react to what you're doing as if it understands.
So I have a misty smiley face in front of me right now?
You do.
I poison spray it.
Okay.
Do I recognize that as like a creature or something? As an evil creature hunter?
Okay. You see the ceiling.
I'm going to down a hard bane. Dead end. No giant.
So it would seem. I'm going to open that contraption.
The oven.
I Eldritch Blast it.
Okay.
It like rots and the hinges fall off, and the door.
It like it rusts and yeah. Okay.
It decays
in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
You still see like the embers and things underneath, but there's like the metal and like the chimney at the top.
Yeah, I'm just kind like blowing the door off.
Disintegrates, so you can see like it's now open.
Mm-hmm.
I make the smiley face follow Hardsbane around as he walks around.
The mist actually seems to be moving out of this room, back into the room you were in. It doesn't seem to want to respond to your smileys anymore.
Aww. It's having fun. Where are you going?
I sigh and look at the devil, the summoning finger.
Could you get a what? Sorry?
Could I get my skeletal raven?
It's familiar with
the familiar.
You know what helps when you're like, oh, hey, I summoned this thing and I did
it! I said it!
He did.
Fucking...
You know what helps when people declare actions? Nope. Opening your fucking ears!
You're getting a regular raven.
My name's Eggnog and GM is so much work!
Motherfucker, I was like, okay, you know what? I was going to be all dramatic and nice about this, but the mist starts coalescing in front of the craven.
I move away.
Okay, you have a raven. You can't control it because I don't have enough time to set that up. Right, what do you want to do with the raven? Don't you give me that bullshit! I did you a zombie in 5 minutes. Fuck off. Or you just discarded it like a used tissue.
Especially when we can use the Mortimer as a head for it.
So, Amelia?
Yes?
I dismissed it.
Wow!
You can have fun.
On the stream again.
And we never heard from Sam again.
You know that mist that was coalescing around the craven?
I step away. From
seems to be coalescing around you now. Hardbane.
Totally no. Worth it.
You know that. You knew that lightning storm? Yeah, it hits you.
So, all fuckery aside, the mist is leaving this room. It seems to be forming up in the center of this circle into something roughly giantess height. And stood there in the actual center of that thing.
I have my actions to declare now.
You want to declare an action? Okay, you declare an action. Go for it.
Is the Tiefling Racial to cast Darkness an action or a bonus action?
Action.
Is an action? Alright. Is this thing in front of us, this coalescing creature, a valid target for me to shift Hex onto?
Yeah.
Okay, I will shift Hex onto it and spend my action on casting Darkness. Into the room, which I can see through because I took the Warlock Demon Eyes.
Okay.
Because I've been waiting all fucking adventure for a chance to cast Darkness on something so I could look through it just to say I did.
Yep, that's fine.
I will make certain Falco is, like, behind me, and I'll take the step so I'm in the way, but if she's gonna hit me, she's gonna come to me.
Okay.
Because I don't have an action swing yet. Strategically, I'm going to wait.
Okay. How big is your darkness, sir?
20-foot radius based on the center, so I pretty much hits the whole fucking room.
Whereabouts is it from?
It's going to center on her.
On her? Okay, so... Yeah, basically, it's the room.
Yeah, it's not maybe exactly the whole room, but fuck it. It's just...
Yeah, it's as good as. Yeah, it's fine. You're like, there's a gap in the corner.
Yeah.
And yeah, so you have that, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And Mortimer's gonna be like, oi, fuck! Who turned out the lights?
Now, if there's no reaction, I'm just gonna move in because I can see her and I'm gonna swing, but that's a whole combat turn, so you have a whole turn to do stuff.
It's okay. Well, she's taking form at the moment. Yeah. So you'll basically, as she's taking form, you'll get your go to go. But then, yeah, she's gonna react to it. So, okay. Treat her as you can actually see her, right? I haven't fucked up the layering on that. Yeah, she's there. Okay. I can't get rid of that fucking... Thank you.
I'm like, fucking click!
Okay,
the scribble of doom!
The scribble of defiance!
Has she fixed herself for dinner?
So she does look very pretty. She looked very pretty for a giant before, but she is now very dainty. She has little curls at the bottoms of her hair. She's like, oh, it's so good of you, darlings, to come here. That's not quite her accent, but it's fine. Hang on. Oh, darlings, thank you so much for showing up here. It saves me the trouble to come and eat you. And you can go in and attack.
Yeah, I'm gonna go in.
Yeah,
I'm gonna bonus action. I'm gonna cast Thunderous Smite.
You need to use your bonus action to transfer the hex, right?
I already did that.
As prior to combat, okay.
Yeah, prior to combat. Yep. That's why I was checking the combat rounds. So she's hexed and in the darkness. Now this turn my action is to cast Thunderous Smite, which charges my mace for a minute.
Okay.
And then swing with advantage because I'm hitting something that can't see me, provided she can.
Can she not see you?
The only thing capable of seeing through magical darkness is the warlock thing, to my knowledge. Which is why I'm hitting that.
And like devil dark sights and other stuff.
She might not be able to see. Okay, so this is a legitimate question I have because I don't know. She has advantage on perception checks relying on smell. Now, you are a particularly strong-smelling decay type individual. So she's going to be roughly aware of your surroundings. She cannot see you.
Yeah, it would still count as an advantage because she can't see me. It's the way invisibility works. Because you can still hear somebody with invisibility,
Okay, so go for it.
And I'm not just saying that because it benefits me. I mean, it totally benefits me.
No, it's fine. You've already been fucking everyone else over. I understand you're being true to it.
Yes!
Is that a crit? Is that an actual crit?
That is an actual nat 20 with everything rolling!
I'm declaring a smite.
You already did.
No, that's Thunderous Smite.
Is a spell that gives me even more smite damage.
I'm going to be so upset if you one-shot my
All right, so this is going to be guy. This is going to be 6d6 for the this is
Although I'm going to be truly impressed if you do manage to take her out with one hit.
If I manage this, I will be so happy. Okay, so it's 2d6 greatsword, 1d6 hex.
Okay.
Doubled for 6d6. Then 2d8 smite damage plus 2d8 thunder damage doubled to 8d8. Plus 3.
Okay.
For strength.
Okay. Yep. Okay. I don't think you can one-shot her. I don't think you can.
Fuck off! It's gonna...
Oh my
fucking
god.
Oh, so 73 damage!
Does your hex add on to that as well?
That is including everything. That is 73 damage.
Is Thunderous Smite concentration?
She has disadvantage, by the way, due to the hex on strength-based rolls. If she still exists after 7 years to the face,
that is that's a sizable. Oh, she still exists.
Oh damn. Okay.
Like
that being
okay,
the case,
do you want? Okay.
I will dismiss my darkness because if she's not dead, then it makes no sense for me to waste everybody else's turns.
Okay. Sure.
Before he dismisses the darkness.
Okay. So let me narrate and then. You can step in before I dismiss?
Go for it. Okay. Do you want to... Okay, for narration purposes, that's about a third.
All right. Such a damn. All right. So, she starts forming, and I immediately, like, the whole room starts to stink and the flies, right? And I'm going to say something about the sacrifices here. And I will, with a motion of my hand, Heartband is like snapping the shackles off, right? Motion of my hand, the whole place is filled with a thick, inky fog. And I will just wade in, and there will be a single crack, like a flash of red energy, right? And I don't know if she makes any sound as a result of that.
I mean, it's a lot of hurt.
How?
Yeah, you crackling energy, thunderous lightning, like you actually hit.
Yeah, like this is a straight up just BAM with the strength of a
fucking,
god. Yeah.
Like you'll hear crunching of bone and like, oh.
And then the darkness will fade and I'll be standing there with a blood dripping maul in my hand.
Okay, so.
But before the darkness fades, Sam wanted to action.
I've also just realized she's technically huge, but we'll go with that.
Whatever. I fuck with size categories all the time.
Yeah, yeah, it's fine.
Just like randomly size things.
Just,
like,
you're gonna be looking up at her, but yeah she's that's
oh, okay. Yeah, so I'm looking up at her.
Yeah, yeah.
Like what?
Yeah, that defiant. Like you're not used to being the little guy, but you're still fucking her day up. Yeah. So
yeah, that's the important part.
Okay.
So after he's like cast his darkness and gone into the darkness, I will. That was 10, 15, 20, 30. Okay, yeah, just out of range. Good. I will throw out my hands and make a large circular motion and push forward, and I will fireball.
Okay.
Centered on the fucking dumb bitch, whatever her name
does
is.
Does that hit me? I mean, I'm resistant to fire damage, so I don't really give a shit.
But... I think it will hit you, yeah. But in character, I don't care if you live or die.
Oh, okay. out of character, I think you can still clip her and miss me if you center the fireball back here, unless it's out of range.
Okay.
If you want.
Let's see. Oh, it's 20 foot? I thought it was 30
foot. It's a 20-foot radius, so it's actually 40 feet across.
So 20... half of the room, basically. If you put it on the wall, it goes halfway into the room.
Yeah, you can do it without actually dealing damage to me. But I don't care if you hit me with it. Like, I'm legit, that's fine. Like, that would be in character for Heartbane, to just not give a shit.
Like,
Mortimer's just gonna casually...
back!
Yeah.
I'm an asshole kind of like... as snidely with my PvP, so... I'll not. I'll
Just throw the fucking damage!
I'm gonna roll the fucking...
That's what.
Good 8, God!
It's 8d8 or 8d10.
8d6, I think it is.
6.
Just click the thing and do the thing.
Oh, that's such a crappy roll!
Wow, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
You rolled 5 ones.
Holy shit!
Okay, hang on, and it doesn't affect her dex, does it?
No, she makes a dex save. There's no, the hex doesn't.
No, your thing doesn't. No. Okay, so she takes the full damage!
She takes full 12 damage!
The mightiest fireball you've ever seen whizzes past her. In
so I might as well just rolled two d6 crits, and they just ignored the other 6 dice.
So you're, let's just put some perspective here. You've summoned, like, the magics from the depths of wherever the fuck your magic comes from. Your minion, as we're supposed to be believing that Craven is.
No one else sees this because it's cast into the darkness.
Okay.
So nobody gets to know that he lived in the fireball!
Apart from you.
Apart from me, I can see everything. So, okay, so it's going to be like, I walk in and then like the rumble shake is the fucking BOOM! Right? And she goes, ah, with a crunch, and then there is the sound of an explosion of fire, and then you'll just hear me go, and then the darkness will fade.
And the darkness drops, yeah.
The darkness drops, yeah.
I look really pissed.
More so than usual.
Yeah.
There's a slight, like, twitch in his mouth, kind of like... which denotes a level of irritated that you've yet seen. Okay, so, Craven's gone, Hubby's gone,
I will.
Sterling?
I will, like, move towards her with, like, you know, not slowly, but,
purposefully.
Yeah, purposefully.
Yeah.
So I'll move, like, over here or something.
If you put that fucking AoE up again.
And I put up the AoE.
You are, aren't you?
Yeah, of course I am. And as I walk, and that summons these like angelic things that like crackles a bit of lightning.
As a note, Tang Mac, she needs to make a DC a strength saving throw DC 14. She has disadvantage. If not, she's pushed back 10 feet. I just looked up the spell, just so you know. I may have moved on to something.
Okay, right. Okay, so a strength save.
Strength save, disadvantage DC 14.
Okay.
Fuck.
She's okay.
I also attack her with my spiritual weapon.
Okay, so she needs to make, like, okay, so the first of all, your spirit guardians is a wisdom save, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
which she fails, so she takes however much damage that was.
12. Okay. And also...
So we'll make sure you get the 12 damage, and you're attacking as well. That will hit.
Nice! Yep. 21?
For 11.
For 11. Good job, guys. She's under half.
Bloodied! Sorry, wrong edition.
And that spiritual weapon will also, like, stay next to her and attack each turn.
That's fine. You fucking neutered her, haven't you? Fuck's sake.
She can't move!
She can't move?
She passed her save against me, right? Yeah, so that thing reduces her speed to zero on a failed save.
Okay. the disadvantage thing, that's on her, that goes with her, right?
The disadvantage on strength checks is hers. Yep. So if she summoned something else to smack me with, then it wouldn't have disadvantage.
No, that's not the thing.
So I didn't attack yet.
Yep, you've still got to go.
Yeah. Is it still feasible to like hop on Kraven and attack off him? As my usual thing.
He seems fine with it, so why not? Let's continue this beautiful friendship that you have.
I summon the rot and decay of all things that are the end. I don't think a bug crawling up my back will bother me.
I don't know, they could be really fucking annoying.
I know.
I preemptively clutch my nose.
Sure, okay.
And just fly in there with like a flurry of kicks, like Liu Kang style, I guess. Like, with
like
fire,
pull the Chun-Li through the air, like,
yeah.
Fucking fist of the North Star going, like, yeah. Okay.
So yeah, lighting them on fire and flurry of blows, so that's
two
points.
Roll it, let's go.
Alright, ready?
If you miss any of these, that's going to be great. Okay, so hits. Miss, 16, hit, 9, 20,
yeah, okay,
hit.
So 16, 9, 26, 22 is a 3-hit?
3-hit.
Does he get advantage for jumping off my back like he did last time? Because that'll be a crit to open up if he does.
That was because you had crit. That was your crit helping him
That's fair.
With that. Yep.
He crit just now as well.
I did just crit her.
Oh, you're a fuck. Yeah.
You shouldn't use that as your excuse to say no. Like, now you painted yourself in a corner.
Okay. The first one hits anyway, but yeah, the first one's a crit. So roll the first one. Yeah, fine. Yeah. I'm on it. Come on. Yeah, I'm nice. Let's go. Everyone hit something. Just fucking let me have my turn.
Now you know how I feel.
I've just realized Mortimer's got to go as well.
Yep.
So all of that is fire, so 20 fire.
Okay. Does that include your crit damage? Which is double?
Actually, it has a thing on top of it. I can spend a key point to do an extra d10, so I'll do that on the crit.
Okay, go for it.
So it does 2d10.
2d10.
Yep. She's still alive.
A fucking huge burning kick to start it off, and then it kind of dies down a bit.
This borderline feral, like, with the speed that he's coming in, like, even you're impressed with this, Kraven. Like, you're a fucking fast guy, right? But this little halfling is nimble as fuck, and the amount of attacks it just unleashes in one go with this fiery, like, emphasis, like, to every blow is really, like...
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
I mean, if you look at it that way,
not a fallen god, but
the flapping of a the flapping of a fly's wings is an impressive speed as well.
So Mortimer, can I kill myself here? So Mortimer's just gonna be like,
are we gonna have the monster die to dungeon masturbation? Really? Oh,
I hope not. I really do.
Oh, god.
So Mortimer's just gonna rage.
Yep.
He's just like, and charge
as like
you know he
shit,
basically
man.
It's like he turns into the flaming skull and will charge in and Ray just gotta go bite her, fuck it.
Nom, 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 nom.
And you rage, you get advantage, right?
No? If he spends savage attacks, yes, but that also gives him advantage to be hit for the rest of the round.
I do also think the savage range also only works on strength things. Not sure.
There's a barbarian class feature called Savage Strikes that gives him advantage.
Yeah, you can specify to do that.
Yeah, but isn't that on strength attacks? That's a dex one.
He is dex based. He's a dex.
Oh,
one.
Yeah, it's probably strength based. Then so no okay. advantage.
There we go. Sadly, nothing. Okay, so it'll be her go. What do I do?
She takes damage from a spirit guardians.
Roll it then. Maybe. Takes all the damage. I don't think you're going to be able to kill her with that, though. She can take a wisdom save for half again, right?
Yep.
Oh, she takes the full damage. Oh my god!
Come on, Spiggy.
13, right?
You know you want
I got this.
Me.
Okay. Yep, fine. Fuck it. She's
you know
just going to attack
me, bro.
You. This is with disadvantage, right?
Yes, because it's a strength-based attack.
Okay, so she makes two attacks with her. Basically, she has this fucking huge like ladle, which she kind of pulls out of her dress, and what it effectively is going to amount to is a Morning Star.
She's going to spoon me.
She's basically going to hit you with a fuck-off ladle.
Spoon me,
and
thanks.
Spoon you. Yep.
You're looking to hit AC 18.
Oh! Ho, ho, ho!
Come on, Boyle. Come on. I got 37. Bring it on.
It's not the crit. It's not the crit because it's disadvantage.
Oh!
But still.
Yes!
Why is it disadvantage?
Because she's hexed.
Because
I declared strength for the static.
Oh, there's a fucking 19 and a 20 as well. Son of a bitch.
Hex is only ability checks, not a test.
Is it ability checks?
It's a different thing.
Yes. I'm double checking the exact thing.
Okay.
H-I-J-K-L-M. Fucking, why do I have to repeat A, B, C, D, E, F, G? I fucking hate the alphabet and the fact that I don't know it. Hex. Has disadvantage on ability checks. You crit.
Okay. So, the crit gives me the plus 8, right? So you take 27. Even if I do another one of those, that's not going to fucking finish you, is it?
Oh, if you hit me with another crit, like, I might drop. I've got 10 HP left.
You could, yeah, you're not gonna die. Fuck it.
No, I'm gonna, I'll just hit zero.
Asshole, you did this to her. Like, she's gonna hit you again. Because she gets two attacks. This is the thing.
Actually, she doesn't go yet. A hellish rebuke. I'm a tiefling motherfucker.
Oh! Okay, yep. Hit me with that. And it'll be at a high level. No, it won't, because although you technically level...
I'm a level 5 character, but the racial ability I'm using...
applies to class level, or is it character level?
It's just it casts as a second level spell.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. I'll take the dex save, which would be with disadvantage, right? No, that's not...
No, not this. She just makes a dex save.
Yeah, yeah. She hasn't got very... Okay, so she'll...
Alright, so she takes 7.
She's still up, but...
All right.
She'll smack you with the ladle, and you'll be like, whatever your hellish rebuke is.
Yeah. Oh, no, she smacks with the ladle, and, like, just as she hits me, like, there will be that shot of decay, the ladle will crack and rust, and it'll rocket up her arm, right? Like, because she touched me.
Okay, so the second attack, which actually does more damage... on the backswing, she will literally smash this decaying ladle, like, straight upside your head.
Yeah.
And the ladle will fucking just shatter into bits. But that's 28 damage. So
yeah, okay,
you are...
So she comes in, right?
Yeah.
She comes in, she clocks me. Boom! I'm gonna turn and I'm going to look. And Oh, what happened? Tony's gonna look. He says, good luck with the...
I hover the misty smiley face in front of him as he falls down.
Yeah, like, since it's taking our turn.
Yeah, it's your turn.
As he's like slowly falling towards me, probably. I can like cure wound, touch him like this. Get off!
Yes!
I make my attacks!
So it's your guy, like, you guys do it in whatever order you want, like, yeah.
I'm a fucking swing!
As I cure wound, I will also use my spirit guard, my,
Spirit guardians go off.
Spirit weapon.
Does a 16 hit?
Yes.
I was gonna use my inspiration.
16 does hit, dude, yes. Hit me with
12
it.
Damage from my spiritual weapon.
Okay. Hang on. So, wisdom save. Sam, roll me your thing. I got this. I'm tracking.
Okay.
Right, so fails to save. So, he takes the spirit
so
weapon stuff.
12. You take 12 initial damage.
So, 12 from Sam.
6 at the start of her next turn.
Okay. You remember that and tell me. She won't be alive next turn. How much was your spirit damage?
12. Spirit Guardians we did before on her turn, so...
Oh, so she doesn't have to worry about that now?
Well, okay, I could technically just move back and then in again.
Yeah, so roll me the damage for that.
You fucking do some stupid dancing bots and that is such bullshit!
Oh, hang on! Did you just walk out of her threat range?
Yes.
So she could get an opportunity attack on you?
Sure. Do that then.
How much health have you got before?
I have 21.
Okay, so she'll get one hit on you as you walk out of range. 26 hits?
Yes.
Oh, 13! 13! What is this shit?
Which means I have 9 life left, and I also use my... I will do Spirit Guardian attack.
Just total this up for me, because I'm losing
I just did, okay.
And since she attacked, future Wrath of the Thunder thing.
Oh my god! Collectively, you're gonna do more than 28 damage, right?
Yes, I hit for exactly 28 myself.
Fuck's sake. So you...
I roll some for fun.
You're gonna mutilate us. So, like, through a combination of walking back in with these spirit guardians and, like, fucking crackles of thunder, and Falco punching like a fucking retard, like, literally just roundhouse in a bullshit, and the acid arrow coming in, like, you know, all of this stuff hits, and then Craven kind of back up. You set, just go to town.
I like she's taller than I am, right?
She is.
So I've got like the crackling mace. I stand back up because the cleric healed me for some reason, right?
I like
just like right. So I stand back up. I grab her by the throat and come down on her head with the strike. And then I'm just if she's dead, like I'm just gonna drag the giant's limp body around and turn to Harbin in the back, and I will say, "Suitable sacrifice, thank you.
Feast."
No, 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 mama, eat the fuck out of this bitch!
I loot the body.
Legit, no, though, I'm actually gonna start just challenging.
Okay. As her blood hits, like, her lifeblood is falling on this altar, I can't actually see the thing, but anyway, it channels, like, you pulled her away, but the blood that's there is filling all these runes, and you can't see this shit because there's too much stuff in the way, but... I will get to it. It's fine. Like, under there is a portal of her blood. Which is the only way you've seen out of this place.
Anything on her body?
Is there any loot?
There's loot on her body, but we'll deal with it.
I'm going to take my... For the sake of the narrative... I'm gonna take my sweet ass time, and by the time I am done consuming her, there will be naught but bones.
That's a pretty gruesome tiefling thing.
I throw up violently behind him at the sight of this.
The sight and the smell. Yeah, you could have a little guts check.
I will take the loot, and then I will just jump out from the portal.
Oh, so you just go through, okay.
After I take all the loot.
Yeah, so we'll deal with loot afterwards, but you will eventually make your way through this portal, and when you make it through to the other side, to find out what actually happens, you'll have to tune in a future episode, because that, ladies and gentlemen, is all we have time for today.